Izzy.
All I see here is him.
Izzy.
I made the shot list for Saturday and Sunday.
Isabel.
I'm working on the call sheet.
Isabel.
By the way, Judge Acker asked you this question. She said, did you negotiate an estimate for the camera? And you were very clear in your answer. You said, I reached out. But you never negotiated it. Because a lot of what you're saying here is, you never quite got to do anything.
I was let go before any of that happened.
No, no. What have you answered yes to so far? You didn't get the permission. You didn't do the call sheet. You didn't finish the call sheet. You didn't negotiate the camera. You didn't do anything
with the camera.
I heard, Judge Corriero.
You know, right from the very beginning, you had a disagreement. You called her a production coordinator. And unfortunately, you also understood your role to be
Izzy
one of the best. That's why you said that you wanted her to work.
Look at the camera.
You asked her to
Izzy.
The crew. Izzy, your word.
I'm one of you. Well, look at this camera.
We had to have phone conference calls to kind of like keep abreast of what's going on.
She couldn't do that.
I had to call her to give her their addresses and telephone numbers.
And the paperwork. You said you completed the paperwork.
I did. I started the film permit process. I asked her to finish it. She never did. When I fired her, she threatened to sue me or make her a producer. I said, I don't negotiate with terrorists.
That's not true. That is not true.
I think we pretty much exhausted.
Let's go. We're going to try to
deliberate. Me, little pug. Eat your own head.
As do all three of us, believe very strongly in the principle.
It doesn't taste good, does it?
The problem is, I can't tell what she did. And it's her burden to demonstrate what she did.
Oh,
you actually eat your head.
And, you know, she had an opportunity to lay it out specifically in the Crew Deal memo, but it doesn't really specify what she was supposed to do at all.
And here at Nauseam, we asked her the same question, and she could never get past, like, a preparatory thing. Like, I picked up the phone, but she never gets beyond, like, did she speak to anyone? What did she do? Did she complete that task? So we would dismiss the complaint. Now, as countersuit, I haven't heard or
Pug.
Seen any evidence of anything false. If she's complaining about the fact that she didn't get paid, she didn't get paid. And then she just complained. You know, it's like people do about their bosses and all. So we would dismiss them. Yeah.
Pug.
You ready?
Yeah.
Izzy B. Izzy B.
Izzy B.
She complained about not getting paid. So we're dismissing that. Ma'am, your complaint. The problem is, we couldn't really get our heads around what precisely it is that you did.
You know, shake
there was
your
no
button
meeting of the minds as to how much that work was going to be worth. You know, when there's that sort of fuzziness in the complaint, it means that you haven't made your case. We wish you the best, but your complaint is dismissed. Thanks very much.
Izzy. Izabel.